Let us stand together.
Today is Monday of the 10th week of Ordinary Time. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the peace and grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God our Father, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with each of you. We pause now to ask God's mercy.
Lord Jesus, you came to gather the nations into the peace of God's kingdom. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you come in word and sacrament to strengthen us in holiness. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you will come in glory with salvation for your people. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, from whom all good things come, grant that we who call on you in our need may at your prompting discern what is right, and by your guidance do it. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the first book of Kings. Elijah the Tishbite from Tishbe in Gilead said to Ahab, "As the Lord, the God of Israel, lives, whom I serve, during these years there shall be no dew or rain except at my word." The Lord then said to Elijah, "Leave here, go east, and hide in the Wadi Cherith, east of the Jordan. You shall drink of the stream, and I have commanded ravens to feed you there." So he left and did as the Lord had commanded. He went and remained by the Wadi Cherith, east of the Jordan. Ravens brought him bread and meat in the morning, and bread and meat in the evening, and he drank from the stream. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our help is from the Lord who made heaven and earth.
Our help is from the Lord who made heaven and earth.
I lift up my eyes toward the mountains. Whence shall help come to me? My help is from the Lord who made heaven and earth. Our help is from the Lord who made heaven and earth. May he not suffer your foot to slip. May he slumber not your who guards you. Indeed, he neither slumbers nor sleeps, the guardian of Israel. Our help is from the Lord who made heaven and earth. The Lord is your guardian. The Lord is your shade. He is beside you at your right hand. The sun shall not harm you by day, nor the moon by night.
Our help is in the name of the Lord who made heaven and earth.
The Lord will guard you from all evil. He will guard your life. The Lord will guard your coming and your going, both now and forever.
Our help is in the name of the Lord who made heaven and earth.
Alleluia, alleluia.
Alleluia, alleluia.
Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven.
Alleluia,
alleluia. Alleluia. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain. And after he had sat down, his disciples came to him. He began to teach them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the land. Blessed are they who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be satisfied. Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the clean of heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are they who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when they insult you and persecute you and utter every kind of evil against you falsely because of me. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven. Thus they persecuted the prophets who were before you. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Jesus, in today's teaching, which is so familiar to us, the teaching of the Beatitudes, shows us and demonstrates how he turns the whole world upside down, that he has come to change the polarities of the magnetism of our common way of doing things, that it's going to be the meek who inherit the land, not the strong. That's contrary to what we have mostly experienced. He is lifting up the lowly. He is empowering those who are small in the world, and he is emboldening them and giving to them the kingdom of heaven. This is a way of giving us strength. Strength interiorly, so that we know that even when we feel small, even when we feel defeated, even when we feel like powers beyond us are moving in the wrong direction, even though it feels we're swimming upstream, God has declared, Jesus has proclaimed that we are blessed and we shall inherit, we shall receive, we shall be empowered. Let all God's children stand to pray. Trusting in God's infinite kindness, we lift before him these our prayers.
That the Lord may continue to bless and care for all the leaders of our church, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Holy Spirit may grant our civic authorities a clean heart to do God's work, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who hunger and thirst may be satisfied through the generous mercy of God, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all who are gathered in this holy place may be brought ever closer to the heart and mind of Christ through his word and sacraments, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all who are sick or suffering in any way may be touched by the healing love of Jesus, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And that all who have died, especially Deacon Ed Lynch, who died recently, and for Gert Koop, we remember it at this Mass, may know the peace and comfort of God's eternal rest, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for the intentions now that each one of us hold in the silence of our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Good and gracious God, hear us and answer our prayers, which we ask through Christ our Lord. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth, the work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine, the work of human hands, it will become for us our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours will be acceptable to God the Father Almighty. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at our hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church. Lord, look kindly upon our service, we pray, that what we offer may be an acceptable oblation to you and lead us to grow in charity. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through your beloved Son, Jesus the Christ, your Word, through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary, fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so, with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory, as with one voice we acclaim, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving you thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving you thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Francis, our Bishop, and all the men and women who serve the church. Remember also our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, especially Gert, remembered at this Mass. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse, with the blessed apostles, and with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. For through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Taught by our Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, but that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave with you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant us peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us offer each other a sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. May your healing work, O Lord, free us, we pray, from doing evil and lead us to what is right. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless us, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in the peace and love of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Have a good day, all.